Hello everyone and welcome to a new video. This one is going to be about Brexit and that's all what people talk about here in the UK. This is not about political views or if Brexit is happening or not. This is solely about how I am planning for Brexit, how my family is preparing for Brexit and what you need to know about Brexit according to the Home Office's website. So what I'm going to be doing is I split this into three categories. I have this all here in my phone. And what I'm going to be doing is I'm going to be talking about what you need to know before Brexit happens, if that happens, which I will talk about in a minute. But also I'll show you the exact information that I have taken from the Home Office's website so that you can see for yourself. Please do your research before you do anything about this. But, you know, let me talk about this, okay? Today is the 24th of October 2019. I'm gonna try to edit and upload this video today as well. So as of today, the planned Brexit date is exactly 1 week away, which is the 31st of October. As the beginning of this video, I have to address this one thing about Brexit. Is it happening or is it not happening? Is it gonna be happening with a deal or a no deal? You know, let's address that issue. On the Home Office's website, right now what they say is the European Union and the UK agreed on the Brexit in principle, and they're just waiting for them to sign, basically. They say on the website, if they sign, there will be a deal, you know, Brexit. If they don't sign, there's still a chance of Brexit happening on the 31st of October without a deal. So I don't know what's gonna happen. It has been this like for ages, it feels like, is it gonna happen? When is it gonna happen? But you know, the government prepared for it. When you go onto the Home Office's website right now, the first thing that you'll see is Brexit information. And the one thing that I wanna talk to you about, if you're living in the UK or if you're trying to, if you want to move to the UK or if you're a UK citizen living abroad, I think the first thing you should do is to subscribe to Brexit, you know, updates on the Gov.UK website. Interesting, on this channel, I'm saying this word subscribe without talking about this channel. But of course, if you're not subscribed, please consider subscribing. Anyway, the first category to plan for Brexit, what I'm doing is about traveling to the EU. I live in London right now. I'm a Turkish citizen. My husband is a German, so European Union citizen. And funny fact, our dog is a Swiss citizen. I know, it's a weird combination. But about traveling to the European Union after Brexit happens, if it happens, there are certain things that people need to be prepared and there are certain things that we absolutely have to plan for. The first thing is the passport situation. I have a Turkish passport myself, so I don't really, you know, have to do anything. I already have a visa to go to the European Union. That's it. Like, if you're not a European Union citizen, you need that anyway, right? For the UK citizens, the Home Office says your passport should meet the new validity rules. And I think they're gonna, you know, expand on that in the upcoming weeks or so. So it looks like right now, the British citizens have to update their passports completely in order to be able to travel to the European Union after Brexit happens. So that's one thing to, you know, keep in mind, that this change has to happen. For my husband, since he's a German citizen, he can actually go to the EU. I don't know what's gonna happen when he's trying to come back to the UK though. I think he can still because he's settled, which we will talk about in a minute as well. I'm so sorry, my voice is horrible again. I'm still not fully recovered, but I really wanted to make this video before, because there are some things that you need to do before it happens, if it happens in a week time. So let me continue with this. The second one is visas. Will people need a visa to go to the European Union after Brexit happens? Well, Home Office says right now for short term, so less than 6 months, visas don't require a visa. But if anything longer than that will happen, you know, studying or working or whatever, that might be, you know, subject to a visa situation. But also this tourist visa concept might also be a thing. They just say for now, and the wording they're always using is very vague, as you'll see. There's nothing certain in this, but I mean, if you have a travel planned just after Brexit, just keep in mind, you know. The next thing is really big for me and big for my husband as well, which is something that I don't think many people think about, is the mobile roaming. So I have a UK number, my husband has a UK number, we travel to the European Union quite a lot, and I think, oh wow, that was British. and I think that the situation will happen that our mobile provider will actually change the rules about data roaming outside of the UK, so we might be facing a really big, really bad invoice if we kept using it as, you know, the way we've been using it for a while. So the thing that needs to be planned for here is actually to contact your operator and ask if they're going to be changing the roaming rules after this happens. If they don't, great, you don't have to do anything, but if they do, you might need to get a European number if you travel a lot, or you might have to get on a plan that won't charge a lot for data roaming. So this is exactly the type of thing that we absolutely have to prepare for. We have to either, you know, get on a plan if our plan is going to change, or get a new number just to be able to use in the European Union. So that's another thing to keep in mind when you're planning for Brexit. Another thing that was really interesting to me is the fact that after Brexit, people like UK citizens might not be able to get the European Union free emergency medical treatments. This is a might situation as far as I saw. So this means one thing: you'll need health insurance, travel insurance. That is another thing that people don't think about within the European Union, because, you know, you don't have to have a travel insurance. As a Turkish person, whenever I traveled to Europe before I moved to Switzerland and then to the UK, I always, you know, bought the travel insurance so that I was sure if anything happens, I'll be covered, you know. So that's one thing that needs to be planned. You have to buy an insurance online. You might have to buy an insurance online, or, you know, from your insurance provider before you go anywhere in the European Union. And that's an additional cost similar to the mobile data roaming situation. Another thing is about driving. So we moved from Switzerland to the UK with our car. Obviously, we changed the car because, you know, you drive on the other side and the car is set up for that here. But if you were planning to drive with your UK, you know, driver's license, the Home Office says you might actually need an international driver's license. That is also something that I have experience with. When I was doing my Erasmus in France years ago, not many years ago, but years ago, I actually got one, and it's basically a driver's license where you can use, which you can use anywhere pretty much in the world, but of course it's another cost. You have to apply for it, wait for it and stuff like that. So again, something else to be, you know, planned and prepared for. Might be the case that you might need an international driver's license and you might not be able to use your UK driver's license. If you're taking your own car, they say, you might need stickers and stuff. Again, I knew this from Switzerland. When we used to live in Switzerland, when we were traveling to Germany and back, which is, again, where my husband's family is from, so we used to go and visit them a lot. We needed to have a vignette, a sticker, on the back of the car, and that is another cost. And again, you have to either order it or you have to buy it from somewhere. You know, that's another thing. But yeah, like the Switzerland experience talks here. If you didn't know about this, I have a video, an old video, but I think the information is still good, all about Switzerland, and you can go and watch it here if you're considering to go there, move there, anything like that. So yeah, driving might be getting a little bit tricky. The next one is about buses. It says that buses to the European Union might not run. And obviously there's a compensation for people who planned or bought the tickets and stuff like that. And this compensation is again provided by the travel insurance. So we go back to the insurance topic. If you're planning anything like that, any trips, any travels, make sure that you're covered by a travel insurance. If you need to be, again, do your research, check the Home Office's website, but it looks like travel insurance is going to be a thing for people who live in the UK. Something good that will happen about traveling is the duty-free, obviously. You can probably start shopping duty-free from Europe back and forth, and I think that's brilliant, you know, cheaper stuff. And the last thing is, pets, traveling with pets. Obviously, we have a dog and we have a blue tongue skink. We won't be traveling with the blue tongue skink, but you know, we occasionally travel with our dog, Cha-Cha. We have never traveled from the UK outside of the country yet, but if you want to, and if we wanted to travel with our pet, the procedure might take up to 4 months, they say. So if I want to go to somewhere with my dog, France, I don't know, Belgium, anywhere, I might have to apply for something and wait for 4 months before I can actually take him with me. So that's another thing to plan for. Obviously, it's a rare occasion, but I just wanted to give you a heads up because since, you know, since I have a dog, I thought since it's relevant for me, it might be relevant for you as well. The second category about planning for Brexit is actually about living here in the UK. This is a big one. It's about the settlement scheme. They announced this while ago, you know, time ago, I don't remember. And we have applied for the pre-settled status when they announced it. Even I think when it was in the test phase, we applied for it. If you're interested in this, I can give you the company's information who did our application. You can do it online yourself as well, but you know, these things are serious matters in my opinion, and I was very happy with the service I've got. So if you're interested, just leave me a comment and I'll answer your comment with the details. The super important part is, and if you didn't know about the settlement scheme situation, which is basically European Union citizens and their family members living in the UK applying for a settlement, telling that we're not tourists here, we live here kind of situation to the government here. They say now on the Home Office's website, if the UK leaves the EU without a deal, you'll only be able to apply if you're living in the UK before it leaves the EU. So you have to apply if you want to keep living here, not as a tourist, but as a settled or pre-settled person, EU national or, you know, EEA national or their family members, you need to get on with this settlement scheme. And it's a very simple, very, very simple application, very fast application at least. And again, if you're interested, I can give you the company's details who did this for us, and we are safe and sound, good to go. And the third part of planning for Brexit is about business. So I'm going to be able to give you some context to this, but I have a UK company. I don't buy goods from outside of the European Union or from the European Union, or I don't sell goods. So for me, it's a little bit easier, but here are some general points that I thought might be interesting for you to know if you own a business here in the UK and if you deal with, you know, other countries. The first one is if you employ someone from the EU, what you need to do might change. Please do check for that. Second one is obviously if you sell to or if you import from the European Union, I think that is a massive change for business owners here. Again, I'll leave a link. I'll show you what it says on the page. I think this is the one thing that the Home Office is really, really stressing this about, like prepare your business, especially if you're importing and exporting from the European Union for Brexit. Immediately. Obviously, there's going to be time to do these things and blah, 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 but this is about planning and this is about being, you know, ahead of things before you face any problems at the customs or whatever. So if you have any of these issues in your business or any of these activities in your business, make sure that you're, you know, taking the right actions to prevent any problems. Another thing that was really interesting and a little bit sad is this sentence again on the website: check your qualifications will be recognized in the EU if you provide services like legal services. So what I understand is if you are, let's say, a lawyer who studied law here in the UK, you might not be recognized as a lawyer in the European Union. That's kind of what I get, like, obviously, you know, a general way of thinking about this. I think it's really important to know because this is, again, as a Turkish person, a problem that I know of. When I first moved to Switzerland with my second master's, I'm a geneticist, by the way, if you didn't know, there was no problems. They immediately acknowledged my studies in Turkey and they accepted my degree so that I could move on with master's. But I had friends who had, you know, studied in Mexico, for instance, and her degree wasn't accepted. So for me, going, you know, coming from Switzerland to here, I didn't have any problems. But I do understand when you study and get your qualifications in one country and you move to another country, there might be some issues where it might not be recognized. And I think that might happen with the European Union and the UK as well. So yeah, something to really, really, really consider about. The other thing is, if you're going to be working with the EU or in the EU, you might need to tell the HMRC about this. Again, I'm not going to go into detail, but obviously it's, you know, a tax situation happening. And the last one is, you have to check whether you'll need to pay social security contributions in the country you're working in. So obviously, if you live in the UK and work in another European Union country, and you're now not paying any social contributions in that country, might change and you might have to pay your social contributions here in the UK and in that country, which is again added costs and again something to be, you know, prepared and planned for. So I think that's about it. I mean, so far at least. I don't know if I should do an update video after Brexit. Let me know if you would like to have an update situation, what happened and, you know, which one of these things are actually happening and, you know, what else is happening and, you know, general situation in London and in the UK. Let me know how you feel about that. And also let me know, actually, that's the one question that I forgot to ask, if you actually live in the UK right now. Comment down below with writing UK so I know that you're watching this living in the UK. And if you have any questions, obviously I'll be checking my comments as much as I can. Answer your questions, I will. So I think that's about it. I'm a little bit stressed, a little bit, you know, excited, a little bit nervous about Brexit, and I think that's the general feeling of the country right now. I think the whole kind of world or Europe right now. Let's see what happens. And yeah, thank you so much for watching. I hope it was useful. I hope this video prepared you to some level about planning for Brexit. You know how I love to be, you know, planned for stuff to happen. And if you're anything like me, or if you want to be more planned and prepared, and if you want to use your time more effectively and you want to be more efficient in life, I think this channel is great for you. And you can definitely join the family by subscribing here. And also, I think these two videos would be great. So if you want to keep watching this, go check them out. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you in the next videos. Bye.